Hey gang, Scott here. I have a gear review for you today. Maybe it's a gear reminder because this is a bag that I know I've talked about in either my podcast or I've mentioned it on this channel. You've seen it in my field videos, and it is the Filter Hive from MindShift, this right here. This holds all of my filters, my remote triggers, lens claws, memory cards, you know, extra batteries, all sorts of stuff. And I have to say, this is probably one of the best $60 investments I've ever made in my landscape photography, because it just puts everything that I need for my filters and changing batteries, memory cards, any of that stuff right at my fingertips. I don't have to be fumbling around with filter pouches or wallets or things like that. I got everything right in this bag. And so I want to give you a rundown of what the bag is and where you can get it. And links are below for all of that kind of stuff. Just to give you a better overview about the Filter Hive and why I continue to swear by it. Okay, so let's start with just the bag itself, size, exterior, all that. So really, size-wise, I'll measure it by my hand. It's about the size of my hand. So this is not a massive bag, but it is good because it holds lots of things. So I'll show you the inside in just a minute. But outside-wise, it's got what you would expect from a MindShift product. Really strong zippers, ripstop on all of the material. It's weather resistant, so I have this out of the ocean a lot. It gets salt spray on it, whatever, just wipe it down, I'm good to go. And there is also a zipper pouch right on the outside where you can put anything that you want to have really ready access to. For me, I keep my remote trigger in there. And then for the back of it, you have a couple of options of how to use it. There's a strap here, and you'll see me use this all the time. I'll drape this around my tripod, so this just hangs off my tripod. But there's also a belt loop, right? You can have this go onto your belt, or if you're using a MindShift rotation bag like that, it can fit on there and have access to your filters without having to stuff it in another part of the bag. So you can just have this either on your belt or dangling over your tripod. That's my preferred way. Now let me show you the inside of this thing here. So we'll open this up. Okay. I'm actually gonna pull out the inner chamber here. All right, so there's a little Velcro on the bottom. You hear the Velcro. And this is the inner sleeve, right? So there are like an accordion style kind of setup. These are for all your square filters or rectangular filters, I say, about 150 millimeter to about 100 millimeter deep. There's six slots for those. And in the front part here, we have the slots for your round filters, right? So you've got room for both kinds. And I use both kinds. I'll have the square ones for my still work, and I'll have round ones that I use for filming. Yet another zipper pouch in case you had anything else you want to try to squeeze in there. And also there's a protective flap, right? So this has got its own flap here to cover up the filter. So even if you have it in the bag, you have a second flap here. And the way I like to have this arranged is to have the flaps kind of counter each other. So I'll have this inner sleeve in here like this, and this flap opens up that way. So when I'm out in the field, this is hanging on my tripod. I'll open this part up. I still have cover for my filters and gear. I'll open this up. I'll get what I need. I can kind of drape this over the top and tuck it in if I need to. I still have got protection even if I need to keep this open a little bit longer while I'm switching something out. Of course, if you don't like that, you can just tuck it right in the back and it's out of your way. And really, that is the whole bag. That is it right there. So how is this working in practice? So here is mine fully loaded, right? And you can see I've got a lot of stuff in there, right? And there's all sorts of things in here that aren't just the square glass filters that we're kind of accustomed to. I've got some drop-ins here. I use a Haida filter system, but they fit in these slots pretty darn well. But now I've got a blank in here, just kind of sitting almost outside of that gray inner pouch, just nestled in there, because there's no glass in that, right? It's just a blank plate. So it's a perfect spot just to kind of drop that in there. If I need it, I've got it. I have some round filters in there, a little hard to see probably, but I use those for my filming. I even have a lens cap tucked in there, just because I have a space for it, I have a slot for it, I'll use it. Drop-in filters, glass filters, and this one at the very back, take this out of here. This is actually my entire filter holder, right? So I've got the holder inside the filter hive as well, just taking up one spot toward the back of my setup here. So I can fit a lot of stuff in here. I like this bag so much. It is really transformative to my photography and putting everything at my fingertips. You know, I've got multiple cameras, I've got multiple filter systems, so why not have multiple filter hives? You know, the only thing better than having one filter hive is having two. So I grabbed myself a second one. You know, I really am invested in this system. It is, invested isn't even the right word. It's really, I made the investment for my landscape photography. This is a key part of what I call my ground-free kit. I want to have my filters, my cameras, everything at my fingertips without having to put something down the ground. For a guy like me shooting at the ocean, or if you're like shooting at rocky terrain or wherever it might be, there might not be a ground to put things down. The filter hive gives me that flexibility, so I wholeheartedly recommend it. It is one of the best $60 investments I've ever made into my landscape photography. Got questions? Go ahead and drop them below. Check the link below there. I hope you'll pick one up, and I really, really do believe you will not be disappointed. Any other questions? Drop them below. Until next time, my name is Scott Davenport. Have fun.